So I got in the Bitcoin space 6 years ago, and I started the first Bitcoin exchange in the UK. My name is Mark Lamb. I'm the founder and CEO of CoinFlex. And when I got in the space, I found a number of exchanges that I was familiar with had kind of collapsed in the first 3 months of getting in Bitcoin. And so I decided to create CoinFloor, which was the first UK exchange, just as a way to give people in the UK a way to buy Bitcoin in something that they trust, something that's safe, and something that they feel like won't go under in the next weeks. And basically, the way I see the futures market today in crypto is a lot like I saw the spot market back in 2012. It's fascinating to people. A lot of people want to buy futures. A lot of people want to trade futures. But people are incredibly terrified of these products. They are worried about the shenanigans that might be going on behind the scenes. And they don't understand them. They're very confusing. So what is CoinFlex? Well, we're the first physically delivered futures exchange. So what does that mean? Well, first, let's look at cash-settled futures. So all of crypto derivatives today, all of the contracts where you're not trading Bitcoin itself, but you're trading a derivative of Bitcoin or a derivative of Ether, are cash-settled. So this means there's a spot market-based index that the futures settle off of, and they settle profit or losses based on this spot market-based index. There's a funding rate calculation that goes into it for any perpetual crypto derivatives, and they're usually inverse or quanto contracts. What does all this mean? I don't know. No one knows. It's very confusing, very complicated, and many, many smart people understand them, and what it's very easy to do, very popular to do, is to game them or manipulate these contracts. The best people in the best position to manipulate these contracts are actually the exchanges themselves, because they're more familiar with the contract and the way the contract works than anyone else in the market. And so what we're doing is, again, physically delivered crypto futures, where at the end of expiry, if you're long, you get Bitcoin. If you're short, you deliver Bitcoin and get cash. In our case, that's stablecoin. What this does is it removes any option for manipulative games or shenanigans at expiry, and it makes the contract really easy to understand. You don't have to worry about indexes, funding rates, quanto, whatever that means. You just realize I'm long Bitcoin, basically, and if I want to take it to expiry, I can, and I'll get Bitcoin. The biggest reason for why we're doing this is because we've looked at the traditional space, and we've decided don't reinvent the wheel. Basically, 98% of all commodity contracts are settled this way. So if you look at gold futures as an example, very few gold futures trading happens in the cash-settled contract. Almost all of it happens in the physically delivered contract. This is simply because people don't trust cash settlement. People, whether it's a retail trader trading a gold future or whether it's a big institution taking on a multi-million or multi-billion dollar position, people do not trust the manipulative shenanigans that can happen in a cash-settled futures contract. Now, the traditional space may know how to do delivery, but what it doesn't know how to do is access, inclusion, and giving retail the ability to actually trade contracts. So this is what a traditional futures exchange will look like. The end customer trades through an ISV, is connected to an FCM, which is their equivalent of a broker. The broker deposits money with a clearing member, and the trades happen on the exchange. Well, this is a huge amount of paperwork, lots of complexity, and if something goes wrong, you've got 5 or 6 or 7 different parties that could all be at fault. So it doesn't connect a personal relationship between the end customer and the venue that they're trading on. This is in contrast to crypto futures exchanges, which are much more peer-to-peer. They're basically end customer, exchange, connecting directly. The exchange performs pretty much all of the functions of the traditional exchange. And obviously, the benefit of that is you know exactly who's at fault if something's gone wrong. You can talk to the owners. You can talk to the team. You don't have endless amounts of paperwork. And one of the biggest benefits of this for especially retail customers and individual customers is in the traditional market, if you short futures or go long futures and the trade goes against you, you could owe your broker hundreds of thousands of dollars. You're personally liable to your broker. You could be carried out. You could have to force sell your house. On a crypto futures exchange, if you deposit $50, $1,000, $1 million, and that trade goes the wrong way, The only thing you can lose is whatever you put in the account. So there's limited liability. And this concept in traditional futures trading practically doesn't exist. And this is an amazing concept that makes futures much more accessible for retail, who really probably shouldn't be trading traditional futures, but now can access the crypto futures markets. Retail are the real whales in crypto. When a lot of crypto entrepreneurs are looking for institutions to basically make a big bid and carry crypto all the way up to $100,000 per Bitcoin and make all our bags go to the moon. But at the end of the day, retail are the real drivers of the space. You know, in 2013, that bull market was entirely driven by retail. It was entirely driven by the inspiration of thousands and millions of individuals all over the world who said, this could be something that changes everything. And in 2017, it was the same scenario. So retail are the real whales in the space. When you look at crypto derivatives, the majority of the volume is retail. And that's something at CoinFlex we're trying to embrace, but also give retail the tools to trade as if they were a professional and give them a contract where they don't feel like they're being, you know, manipulated or scammed in some way. So when we look at the futures space today in crypto, and when we think, where is this going to go? Where should this be? What is the future of futures? We look at the traditional markets 20 times futures volume versus spot volume. So we look at the crypto markets, it's about 1-to-1. So spot volumes in crypto today are several billion dollars. Well, crypto futures volumes are about the same, several billion dollars per day. And ultimately, we think in the current market conditions, if leverage is applied, if people understand these contracts, if there's proper hedging, if people can make big bets and effectively use these to speculate on the Bitcoin price, then Bitcoin futures should look similar to traditional futures in terms of the ratios. And so what that means is ultimately the current futures volumes should be more like $30 billion a day. And that's what we believe the current market should be able to sustain. That's where we want to get to, and we want to be the drivers of that growth from, let's say, 2 to 3 to 30. So that's where we see our role. And who are we? Where do we come from? Why should you trust us? Why should you use us over any other new exchange? You know, new exchanges are a dime a dozen. Well, we're backed by a number of market-making firms. At the end of the day, when you're an exchange, liquidity is the most important thing you need. It's what gets you past that initial network effect. It's what allows your customers to get their orders matched. So we're backed by Amber AI, Grapefruit Trading, Alameda Research, B2C2. We also have a number of crypto OGs in there, Mike Komoransky, Roger Ver, amongst others, and then also very large investment funds. Polychain Capital are probably one of the largest funds in the space, DCG, Digital Currency Group, one of the most prolific investors, and Dragonfly Capital Partners. And also, I'd like to talk about Trading Technologies, one of our kind of founding partners and big shareholders. Trading Technologies, also known as TT, they're the largest futures trading platform in the world. They trade, their customers, through their systems and through their trading platforms, trade about $1 trillion worth of futures a day. So this is on all the big traditional exchanges, CME, markets around the world. Futures traders, whether it's prop trading firms, banks, or brokerage firms, are actually trading using TT's technology. And the thing we like about TT, and the reason why we partnered with TT, is because they give a manual user who might not know how to program or know how to implement an algorithmic strategy all the tools they need to trade like a professional. So, this talk is titled The Democratization of Trading and with Offshore Futures. We want to see everyone trading futures. We want to see vastly more numbers of people trading futures. Lots of people in crypto have a Binance account. Very few people in crypto actually trade derivatives. We think with TT, with the physical contracts, and with the linearity of the contracts, they can be much easier to understand, and people can have all the tools they need to trade at the same level as someone who's a professional trader or a fund. So this was the big question for us, because at the end of the day, every exchange starts out with a volume of zero. And how do you get off that initial hurdle? How do you get that initial liquidity? And how do you, how do we fulfill our mission? We're trying to become the biggest crypto derivatives exchange in the world. We want to beat BitMEX, beat OKX, beat all the other guys. Well, we looked back to our roots, which were really the roots of Bitcoin. And so back in the day, you could go to a faucet, you could get some free Bitcoins, you could mine on your computer, you could get 50 Bitcoin. And that initial liquidity bootstrapped the Bitcoin network and helped make it what it is today, which is this massive economic powerhouse powering transactions all over the world with a market cap measured in tens of billions of dollars. And at one point, it was hundreds of billions of dollars. And so we decided to create our own coin, Flexcoin. It's not an ICO. We're not selling any. If anyone says they can get you in on some sort of pre-sale, they're lying to you. It's a trade-driven mining exchange coin, where if you trade on the exchange, you receive flex for trading. It's takers receive it only. We've already got lots of market makers. Lots of market makers are interested in the exchange, so we don't want to give any more incentives to market makers. Trading on the futures as a taker allows you to receive flex. And anyone who spends flex can get 50% off of a day's trading fees. So you spend a fixed amount of flex and you can get 50% off of a whole day's trading fees. There's a limited supply, and any flex coins that are spent are basically burned. So the supply is limited, and over time it goes down. And basically, this is our view, the best way to bootstrap that liquidity and get early users to be excited about the platform, because rather than just trading for the P&L of Bitcoin futures going up or down, short, and et cetera, cover out, you actually get this other thing as well. So it kind of creates a side game along with the existing trading. So we're really excited about Flex because we want to build a community around CoinFlex, and this is kind of one way we see of doing that. So with that, I'd like to open it up to questions, and we're really glad to be here at Token 2049. Any questions? I don't know if there's a mic being passed around, so just feel free to call them out or raise your hand. Yeah. Yeah, so anyone, any prop trading firm, any institution, or any individual that's already connected to trading technologies will automatically have access to CoinFlex. And anyone that's not on TT's platform will be able to access any of TT's crypto markets, predominantly CoinFlex, for free. So, yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.